Hello everyone, welcome back to PJ Chen Design Channel. Today we are going to talk about this simple ring shank design. It's a little bit offset and with the bead setting on the top. Are you ready? Let's get started. When we're starting a ring, we always need to start it at the front view. This is my suggestion. And then I will, for my demonstration, we're gonna set a diameter for 16. And then you're going to set it up exactly what ring size you're going to have. Then we wanna come into the top view. In order to make it symmetrical, I'm going to turn the grid snap on and I'm gonna use the curve. So the curve will snap on the grid. I want to starting somewhere is longer than 16 millimeter there. So I'm going to snapping over here, counting somewhere close to the centers right here. You can either snapping there or not, or you can coming over here directly. And I'm gonna coming over like that, as long as it's longer than our ring shank. Alright, so I'm going to set the stone is roughly about 1.5, 1.6 millimeters. So I will need to have it, I will need to see the distance in between. Then we are going to use the command, it's called offset curve. And I want to offset on the both sides for 1 millimeter each side. So that is kind of giving us a guideline for what is the next where the next one is going to be. I'm going to create another layer and turn this layer into the red color and come over here and I want to draw a line to follow it. So I'm kind of eyeball it, and I at this point I can turn the grid snap off, and we're gonna come over at this layer. And then we're gonna starting somewhere roughly about this. And again, I need to make sure it's slightly touching there so it will have a better casting result, because you don't have too much of a gap in between. So I wanted to have this distance eyeball it is less than 1 millimeter. Alright, so I can have it, it's just a slightly touching is fine. And then we are going to offset again with this curve. That's offset 1 millimeter on both sides. So then this is the second part right there. The third one, I'm going to use actually this one and continue to offset twice and trimming smaller, because on my design, I do want this one to be open, but next to each other, this one I wanted to link together. So the best way to do is to offset from here one time and then pick up this one and offset one more time here. I'm going to move it this one and create a new layer. And then moving that one, moving that two curve into this layer and turn this one into the purple layer. So then it will be easier for you to see later on. I also want to make a copy to put it in there. Okay, so let's turn it off. Everything else like this one, let's turn it off so we can work on the center first. Now we have the center three line. We pretty much don't need the middle one, so I'm just gonna go ahead and hide it. And we need to have those curve in this curvature, but follow this round or circle shape there. So the command we are going to use is called curve from two views. And we're gonna click this one and this one, and also click this one and this one. So it kind of give us the curve of it. So this will be the ring shank that we have, and I'm going to creating the profile. So the first profile, let's go come over here. I'm gonna use the rectangle, and you have 3 point. So I'm gonna snapping into the quadrant, and coming out for whatever thickness that you want. I'm gonna set it up for 1.5 there. And then after having that, I'm just gonna simply to making a copy and going from the endpoint to this point there. All right. So now we have this over here. I'm just gonna temporarily hide this one. Oh, accidentally too far away. So let me move this one back here. All right. So now we have everything set up. That's making into the solid. We wanna go sweep to rail, and this is rail one, rail two. This is cross-section, and make sure the arrow is aligned, okay? And then we will get our first shank there. Alright, so now we have the first shank. We're gonna come over here to talk about the second shank. We still need that circle back. So let me making a copy into this layer. And we're gonna turn that off, right? So the second one, again, we don't need the middle one, middle line. And then we need to do exactly the same thing. We want to do curve front to view. First and second, and first and second. Right, so now we get those. We don't need the one on the bottom, so we're going to trim the bottom off. Then we get something like this. With this one, I actually do want to share this profile, so I'm going to make a copy to this layer and turn it off and kind of moving that one with the endpoint and snapping into here. Okay, so now we have our profile. We just need to go ahead to use the sweep to rail, and we're gonna rail one, rail two, and this is the cross section. And we will get this one. Let's turn on the first ring shank and see if that works. I might need to get it a little bit closer, but we can adjust it later. Okay, now let me turn off this one and turn on the third one there. On the third one, the third element right there, we're gonna do the same thing, repeating. Let's do a curve front to view. So one and two, and again, one and two. All right, so let's turn off the rest of them. And now this is our third one. We're gonna again making the same curve, and we wanna copy to that curve there. And we are going to again moving that one from this endpoint to the endpoint over there. Okay, if you want to go ahead to trim the bottom off, you could, because we no longer need those. So now I'm taking a look on this one. I actually don't need it go all the way up. That's not my design. So I'm gonna coming over to a top view, kind of a giving a guess where you want them to be trimmed, and turn this off, and we can have that one to trim all the extra off. All right, so now it's shorter. Let's go ahead to doing the sweep. We're going to go sweep to rail, and you got rail one, rail two, cross section, and then you got the curve there. So if we turn on all three of them, then we got something like this. Now I just want to make sure that just in case I regret, I want to change the shape or things like that. I don't want to bowling with this basic form. So usually what I do is I creating a new layer, and I make copy of the only things that I needed, and including the original ring shank. And I want to make a copy to that layer, and I can turn the rest of them off. Okay, so now I have it very clean, and it's something like that. If you want this to be more overlapping, I'm gonna turn on the gumball and just have them moving a little bit, so it has a better bowling and you will have the better casting as well. Okay, so now once we finish there, we need to have this to the other side. So let's go ahead to cap all of them first. And then we want to copy those two. Instead of using mirror, I'm using the rotate. Make sure copy equal yes. Let's click on the zero and rotate it 180 degrees. So we get something like this. Okay, so now I have it on the other side. And now we need to thinking about how we're going to finish the rest of it. That's using the rectangle tool, and we want to create a profile on the bottom, and we're gonna create the same profile on this side using the rectangle tool, snapping there and snapping on that corner too. On the bottom, I would like to create another profile, but this one is smaller and also thinner as well, and then so that way I'm going to make it taper for this bottom of a ring shank. So the command we're going to use is under the surface, you have sweep one rail, you click on this rail, and you want to click on the profile that we just had in the order, like this. and make sure this is all aligned. And then so we can create a taper ring shank on the bottom. Okay, so the rest of it is stone setting. You can do a bead setting or the channel setting, depends on how you like on your design. I have a stone setting course online. You can click on this link on the right top corner, or I do have a for free video for a whole playlist for the stone setting. And for friends that donated to my channel, I really appreciate it and want to thank you. Your donation is going to help me to buy the new equipment for making videos and update my software. The donation link is in the description below, and I would like to thank everybody for watching. I'll see you next time.